Would you please welcome me and Dicko Dickinson? Dicko, I mean, I have to say, when you were evicted, you took it well, but I didn't. I was really shocked. I assumed that it was top three and it was just a question of which colour medal. What happened?
No, look, it's very kind of you to say that, but today I am proudly South Africa's biggest loser.
So. You were a beast when it came to the ball challenge. You had to eat a lot of balls in there. the question we have is what they tasted like.
Well, I had a warthog testicle, a zebra testicle and a kudu testicle. I didn't even know what a kudu was, let alone how big their balls was. So it was a bit of a challenge. If I can describe it this way, it tastes like the worst pate you've ever had. So, and it's just so dry in your mouth. I couldn't get any saliva up and I was chewing it for what seemed like hours. But, yeah, look, I must admit, I tucked three of them away. When it comes to ball eating, I was in mid-season form, shall we say.
Well, Dicko, we love your honesty about the taste review of the balls, but also while you were in the jungle, you were very open and honest. You opened up about what happened with the infamous Paulini gold dress saga as well, and you got very emotional about that. Was there ever any point that you forgot the cameras were there?
Look, this production is really, really skillful, and they design it in a way that after a couple of days, the production just melts away. And you forget that you've been filmed and recorded, and it really gives way to some fabulous, long-form, interesting discussions. And we were always really proud because it's a wonderful cast this year. There's a lot of love down there, and it enabled us to tackle some pretty gnarly subjects in some great discussions that never really got beyond the bounds of respect. And we're proud that if they did make the edit, those sort of conversations landed in Australian lounge rooms. So, yeah, this program gets it right. I was really astounded because I must admit, I thought it was just another daft reality show, but it was so much more for me.
And you still said, sign me up!
I reckon you don't forget when you eat zebra balls, though. I reckon that still stays with you. You bonded with our Liz and Pete. Do you think they'll go all the way, Dicko?
Look, I don't know. Pete is naturally funny. As we all know, most comedians are racked with anguish and self-doubt, but Pete just breezes around the camp, just tickling people to death. and look, Liz Ellis, I have a devotion to that woman that borders on the unprofessional. Ooh. She is a born leader. She's whip smart, wickedly funny, and she's the winner that I think Australia needs. So I think she's going to go all the way.
Oh, that's not a prediction. That's a demand. Yeah. Australia must vote for Liz.
Yes.
Wow.
Yes.
All right. There we go. You can catch more of Nature bringing out the best and dishing out the worst to our poor celebrities right after us. Dicko, thanks so much for speaking to us.
Thank you, guys.
All right. Liz Ellis, the PM, I think. I think that's the natural follow.
Every vote.
Yeah, everyone.